So next we can see the single stub matching problem. Okay, so the problem is a 75 ohm lossless transmission line is matched with 100 minus j 80 ohm load with using single stub. Calculate the stub length and its distance from the load corresponding to the frequency of 30 megahertz using Smith chart. Okay, so you know, in order to plot the load impedance in the Smith chart, you want to normalize the value. Okay, so given ZR value, that is the receiving end impedance value, is 100 minus j 80 ohm. Then in the value kuduthirukanga. So R0 characteristic impedance is 75 ohm and frequency they have given 30 into 10 power 6. So in order to found the normalized load impedance, what is the formula? ZR by R0. Okay, so what is ZR? ZR 100 minus j 80 and R0 is 75. So when you divide it, you got 1.33 minus j 1.07. Okay, so now you want to plot this value in the Smith chart. So 1.33. Okay, so in order to plot 1.33, you want to see the constant S circle. So 1.33 minus j. So minus means you want to see below the real axis. Okay, so 1.33, this is 1.2 and this is 1.4. So here 1.33. Okay, and 1.07. So here 1.07. Okay, so when you connect this 1.3 and 1.07, it is joining at this point. Okay, so it is mark this point as A. Okay, mark this point as A and draw a line from the center, that is from O to A. So the value is 1.33. Okay, 1.33, that is 1.33 minus J. J nala nama keela minus term, negative term nala keela mark pannirukku. Okay, 1.07. So it is 1.2. It is 1. Okay, 1.07. More or less here in the term level. Okay. So join this point and mark a line OA. Okay. And with OA as radius, take OA as radius in the compass and draw a circle. Okay. And now extend this line. Okay, extend this OA line. You got the admittance. So it is, and mark that value as B. So you want to find the value. So it is 0.5 and this line is 0.46 and the arc is, it is joining at 0.4. Okay, so this point is 0.46 plus j 0.4. So extend this line. Okay, extend this admittance line. So you got this is B dash. Okay, it is B dash and this value is admittance value is 0.46. So here constant S circle is 0.46 and the in reactant circle it is 0.4. Can you understand? So we got a circle and we got the impedance, normalized impedance and normalized admittance value. Okay, normalized admittance value. And now see, in order to find the distance in single stub matching, it is very very important to draw the unit circle. Okay, unit circle every draw pananu. So it is one value. Okay, the center point. Okay, see the center point is 1. In the 1 la dhaan nama enna pannum unit circle draw pannum. Okay, make a dotted dash. So neenga hand vechi draw pannikalam. Okay, unit circle in the circle 1 la join agra the circle you want to draw as the unit circle. Then enna pannum unit circle in the point la inde adla point la meet agra ella points ay circle draw pannidu. Okay, so it is a unit circle. And now you want to mark, so this constant S circle you want to see, constant S circle, unit circle, in the edathila meet pannu. There are two meeting points. One is this meeting point, another one is this point. Then are two meeting points. One is the term and other meeting point is this one. Okay. So one is this one and other meeting point is this one. And now see, from the admittance, you want to move in clockwise direction. So unit circle in the point in the meet panata, the intersection of constant S circle and unit circle you want to find. Okay, and mark that point as a C. From the load point B, that is the admittance point, the load point B, the load point A impedance, and from the load point B, okay, B you want to move towards clockwise direction. Clockwise move panata. Can you understand? So first you want to draw the constant S circle and mark the impedance and admittance value. Next, draw the unit circle. Okay, and from the point B, move in clockwise direction. Clockwise la move panambodhu, unit circle la rendu point irukku. One in the point and one in the point, meet pandra point. There are two meeting points in the unit circle with constant S circle. So you want to move in clockwise direction from the load point B, okay, from load point B, and you want to choose the nearest load point. Okay, ninga edha choose pannona nearest point. So here there are two points, one is this one and this one. You want to choose clockwise la move panumbodhu edhu nearest value la varudhu, idana nearest varudhu, idhu innu move panni varanum. So this is the nearest point. So idha nama enna value nu eduthukonu, point C nu eduthukonu. Okay, so you choose the intersection of constant S circle and unit circle, the nearest point from load B. So we had chosen this as the point C. Okay, point C, and extend this line. Okay, so what is point C? So epome in the real part 1 ada irukku, because unit circle la irukanaala constant S circle value 1. And what is the reactance value you want to find? So this arc value is 1. Okay, so J1 value 1 plus J1 value. Okay, so this point C is 1 plus J1. So now extend this line also and mark a C dash. So what is this point? So single step matching la the distance value ellame nama outside circle la dhaan paakanum. Okay, ellame edhula dhaan paakanum, outside lambda value, wavelength value ellame outside la ulla values dhaan paakanum. So idhukku munadi nama distance V minimum from adellam paakumbod the inside in the values paathukitta. So here in order to find the distance, okay, want to see the wavelength circle, that is the outside outer circle. So in the wavelength circle, when you extend B, B dash, what is this value? 0.07 lambda. And if we extend this value C dash, what is this value? 0.161 lambda. And now in order to find the distance, you want to subtract this value. So 0.161 minus 0.07, the value is 0.091 lambda. Okay, so it is the distance of the step. Okay, that is the, sorry, location of the step. Then namak enada location of the step. Okay, distance of the step. And next, okay, next you want to find the length of the step. In order to find length, nama enna pandrom, point C la ulla imaginary value, idu dhaan enadhu susceptance value. You want to take the susceptance value. If it is a positive value, means you want to take the negative susceptance. So here it is plus J1. So if it you take minus value, negative sign, you want to mark in the negative na enga mark pannuvom, below the real axis, correct? So minus 1. So minus 1 enga irukku? So it is 1. Okay, it is 1. So minus 1 inda edathila irukku, mele plus 1. Okay, so here minus 1 value. So mark this point is minus 1 and join from the center value O. So take this as D and the extra length value is D dash. So idu enga meet agudhu, enna value la meet agudhu? Outside circle la paarenga. So the value is 0.375. so you want to measure the length of the stuff from the maximum value. Okay, so here the maximum value is 0.25 lambda. So if you subtract these two value, you got 375 lambda minus 0.25 lambda is length 0.125 lambda. Okay, so this is the procedure for finding the single step matching. So first of all, you want to find the normalized load impedance and draw a constant S circle. Okay, and next extend this value and find the admittance, mark the point B, and extend the value and mark the point B dash, find the length wavelength value. Okay, that is 0.07 lambda. And next you want to draw the unit circle and find the intersection of this constant S circle and the unit circle. The point, it may join at two points, but you want to choose the nearest point from the load B point. Okay, so it is the nearest point. So here you extend this line, so you got the length value, and you can find the you can find the distance of the stub. Okay, distance stub called distance find panikla. Okay, by measuring this, that is the location of the stub. Okay, so if you subtract this, you got the location of the stub. Next, you want to find the length of the stub. In order to find length, we want to take the susceptance value. So here plus J1 means you want to mark in the minus J1 value, minus 1 value. So here it is minus 1 and extend this value. Okay, if you extend this value, and next the maximum value will find panna. So maximum value is 0.25 lambda. So if you subtract this, you got 0.125 lambda. Okay. And now, see, listen, in the question, they had given the frequency value was 30 megahertz. So you can easily find lambda. What is the formula for lambda? C by F. Okay, so C value, you know, and f value also, you know, you got 10 meter. Okay, so now in the place of lambda, you want to substitute 10. So if you subtract this, so first value, that is the location of the stub, you got 0.91 meter, and the length of the stub, if you multiply with lambda 10, you got 1.25 meter. Okay, thank you.